नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। वर्शिपिंग टेक्स्ट 1, टेक्स्ट 2 एंड टेक्स्ट 3 ऑफ चैप्टर 3, द लॉर्ड्स फर्स्ट टाइम्स आउट ऑफ वृंदावन ऑफ थर्ड कैंटो, द स्टेटस को ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। टेक्स्ट 1, उद्धव उवाच ततः स आगत्यपुरम स्व पित्रोश्र चिकीर्षया शम बलदेव संयुतः निपात्य तुंगाद्री पूयुथ नाथम हतम व्यकर्षद व्यसुमोजसोर्व्याम। श्री उद्धव सेड देयर आफ्टर लॉर्ड कृष्ण वेंट टू मथुरा सिटी विद श्री बलदेव एंड टू प्लीज देयर पेरेंट्स दे ड्रैग्ड कंस द लीडर ऑफ पब्लिक एनिमीज डाउन फ्रॉम हिज थ्रोन एंड किल्ड हिम पुलिंग हिम अलोंग द ग्राउंड विद ग्रेट स्ट्रेंथ। किंग कंस डेथ इज ओनली ब्रीफली डिस्क्राइब योर because such pastimes are vividly and elaborately described in the 10th canto. The Lord proved to be a worthy son of his parents even at the age of 16 years. Both brothers, Lord Krishna and Lord Baldev, went to Mathura from Vrindavan and killed their maternal uncle who had given so much trouble to their parents, Vasudev and Devki. Kansa was a great giant and Vasudev and Devki never thought that Krishna and Balram Baldev would be able to kill such a great and strong enemy. When the two brothers attacked Kansa on the throne, their parents feared that now Kansa would finally get the opportunity to kill their sons whom they had hidden for so long in the house of Nanda Maharaj. The parents of the Lord, due to parental affection, felt extreme danger and they almost fainted. Just to convince them they had actually killed Kansa, Krishna and Baldev pulled Kansa's dead body along the ground to encourage them. Text 2. Sandipaneha sakrit proktam brahmadhitya savistaram tasmai pradadvaram putram mrutam pancha jano darat. The Lord learned all the Vedas with their different branches simply by hearing them once from his teacher Sandipani Muni, whom he rewarded by bringing back his dead son from the region of Yamlok. No one but the Supreme Lord can be well versed in all the branches of Vedic wisdom simply by hearing once from his teacher. Nor can anyone bring a dead body back to life after the soul has already gone to the region of Yamraj. But Lord Krishna ventured to the planet of Yamlok and found the dead son of his teacher and brought him back to his father as a reward for the instructions received. The Lord is constitutionally well versed in all the Vedas, and yet to teach by example that everyone must go to learn the Vedas from an authorized teacher and must satisfy teacher by service and reward, he himself adopted this system. The Lord offered his services to his teacher Sandipani Muni, and the Muni, knowing the power of the Lord, asked something which was impossible to be done by anyone else. The teacher asked that his beloved son who had died be brought back to him, and the Lord fulfilled the request. The Lord is not therefore an ingrate to anyone who renders him some sort of service. The devotees of the Lord who always engage in his loving service are never to be disappointed in the progressive march of devotional service. Text 3. Samahuta Bhishmaka Kanyaya Ye Shriyah Savarnen Bhubhush Yaisham Gandharva Vritya Mishatam Swabhagam Jahare Padam Murdni Dadhat Suparnaha. Attracted by the beauty and fortune of Rukmini, the daughter of King Bhishmaka, many great princes and kings assembled to marry her. But Lord Krishna, stepping over the other hopeful candidates, carried her away as his own share, as Garud carried away nectar. Princess Rukmini, the daughter of King Bhishmaka, was actually as attractive as fortune itself because she was as valuable as gold, both in color and in value. Since the goddess of fortune Lakshmi is the property of the Supreme Lord, Rukmini was actually meant for Lord Krishna. But Shishupal was selected as her bridegroom by Rukmini's elder brother, although King Bhishmaka wanted his daughter to be married to Krishna. Rukmini invited Krishna to take her away from the clutches of Shishupal. So when the bridegroom Shishupal came there with his party with the desire to marry Rukmini, Krishna all of a sudden swept her from the scene, stepping over the heads of all the princes there, just as Garuda carried away nectar from the hands of the demons. This incident will be clearly explained in the 10th canto. Hare Krishna!